and whatever comes our way.
Going back to the 60s again.
What do you mean, Foxy? It's 1964.
No, hon, it's 2022.
Oh, that's harsh. But does that mean you have a computer yet?
Yeah, hon, we have three.
Really? Does that mean we won Vietnam?
Pick something happier, please.
Well, did I ever tell you that time I went to Woodstock with my brothers?
Yes, but I feel like you're going to tell me again.
Okay, Foxy. So here's the scene. So, I'm sitting here on a field out at Woodstock, listening to the soulful music of Jimi Hendrix. I'm an old man, old lady, don't know where I am, and I hitched all the way here. And bam, in walked a foxy lady. And I flipped my wig. She was out of sight. Dynamite. And one cool cat. That's all I remember about Woodstock. Oh, and trying to hitchhike my way back home. Took me 5 days. And I don't remember much years after I drank that funny looking water and saw those happy little trees.
Hon, that was me. I was the foxy lady.
Damn, woman, what happened
to you? Did you drink that funny water too?
Okay, Sunny. But while you were drinking your water and sniffing those trees,
those were some pretty good trees.
There was some pretty rough stuff going back at home. At college, me and my girlfriends were protesting everything from civil rights to women's rights and the Vietnam War. Don't you remember?
Nope.
Love not war! Love not war! Love not war! Love not war!
Well, howdy, Foxy ladies. What are you griping about?
Don't you know what's going on in the world right now? People are being oppressed. There's a war with a whole other country. And there's people dying. You dig?
You're bumming me out too much. You ladies are too foxy worrying about this stuff so heavy. Why don't you come with me and my brother? We could listen to some groovy music and drink some funny water. We won't be worrying about nothing.
Okay, and what's your name again?
My name is Sunny, and I want you to be my honky-tonk woman.
All right, Mick Jagger, but I don't have time for funny games. We're at a real crossroads right now. Don't be such a flippin'.
All right, you bum me out again, but keep on truckin'.
Remember that time I met you at the Ed Sullivan Show in 1964? Man, that scene was far out. I met some groovy mama there, too. So many foxy women at that show.
That was me, Sonny.
That was you? Woman, what happened to you?
Thanks a lot, Sonny. But for your information, I'd even lay eyes on you and your hippie threads. Besides, all the girls were looking at Ringo, Paul, John, and George.
Okay, woman. Pumped me out again. Let's talk about something else. Aim loose. I don't remember anything else.
Let me refresh your memory. Do the words Apollo 11 and JFK ring a bell?
Ain't that the man who got shot on the moon?
Our Shamas really got kicked up a notch, hasn't it? Anywho, JFK was shot, but not on the moon. Hmm. He was assassinated by Lee Harvey Oswald. But I don't want to get into that.
Oh yeah, Vietnam, right?
Shut your trap and let me talk. Let me lay this on you, Sonny. Main Street, 1969. Apollo 11, Neil Armstrong on the moon, and the crowd standing outside Marshall's TV shop.
Oh yeah, now I remember. I met a foxy lady there.
That was me, Sonny.
What happened to you?
Get real, Sonny, and think about it. This is an important moment of time.
Wait, okay, someone's coming to me. There's a man wearing those uniforms. You know what I'm talking about? He tied himself to an airplane, somehow. Tied some proper Mentos to get by with him. Saw some Foxy News report. Not you. And said one small step for man. And what else does he say?
Yeah, that's not what happened, but close enough.
Hey, but I do remember something for sure.
And what's that?
The freshmen are going to win the Spirit Week.
Okay, so what movie do you guys want to watch?
We should watch a 90s movie. You know, it is our whole theme for Spirit Week this year.
Yeah, that would probably help with our ideas for Spirit Spot. We should watch Clueless. I love Cher's style.
Same. I wish I had her closet.
I'm not watching some chick flick. Let's watch a classic Fight Club.
Who said I wanted to watch guys fight for 2 hours?
Do you even know what Fight Club is about?
Yeah, it's people who fight in a club. Pretty self-explanatory.
Hey guys, what you doing?
Just talking about Spirit Week. We got the best decade.
What, the 80s? The 90s, you idiot.
Okay, well, what movie do you guys want to watch since we can't seem to agree on anything? We're watching a 90s movie to guide us for the Spirit Spot.
Is Titanic a 90s movie? Because if it is, it has my vote.
Yes, hands down best movie of the century.
Dude, are you kidding?
Do you guys really want to watch a romance movie right now? I say we watch a horror movie. Scream would hit.
What about The Truman Show? That movie's pretty trippy.
That's it. I'm literally putting on Clueless.
Oh, no, you won't. We're watching Fight Club. No way, dude. We just watched Fight Club.
Where am I?
I heard the Frosh are gonna win Spirit Week.
Ugh, get off of me, as if. Am I Cher from Clueless?
Where am I? Where is everybody?
Get in line, boy! Get in line! Alright boys, welcome to Spirit Week. First rule of Spirit Week is, do not lose Spirit Week. Second rule of Spirit Week is, do not lose Spirit Week! The third and final rule of Spirit Week is, if you're in the class of 2025, you have to participate.
Yeah!
I wanna go home! I wanna go home!
Jaden, where are we?
The ocean.
Why are you all wet?
Probably because we're in the middle of the ocean.
Oh, yeah.
Is it just me or is it freezing?
I mean, it's not freezing, but definitely a little brisk.
Maddie, you're on a door. You don't move over.
No, what? This is my door. Go find your own.
You're so cold.
Quit being such a mad.
Maddie, can you promise me one thing?
What? Promise you what?
Promise me, if I don't make it, that the sophomores are going to win Spirit Week this year.
Wow, and here I was finally thinking he was going to say something nice.
Where the hell did everybody go? Better go find them.
I always feel like somebody's watching me, and I have no privacy. Oh, I always feel like,
man, for sure thought Justin Tilton would be in here. And in case I don't see you again, sophomores, good afternoon, good evening, and good luck.
Allie? TK? Is anybody there?
Why don't you want to talk to me?
Who is this? And where am I?
Tell me your name and I'll tell you mine.
Very funny, TK, but the joke's over.
What's on your mind?
You're asking me what's on my mind right now?
That is what I said, isn't it?
Well, right now I'm wondering where my friends went and whose kitchen I'm in.
Well, what's after that?
Probably what we're gonna do for the Spirit Spot. Spirit Week's in a month and we still have nothing.
You can give me inspiration?
Why not? What?
too soaking wet.
Why are you bleeding?
Yeah, what happened to you?
You guys were asking questions and ignoring the fact that we literally all just disappeared for like 20 minutes.
Speaking of disappearing, where is TK?
Yo, I just had the most trippy dream ever. Soaking wet.
Why are you bleeding?
Yeah, what happened to you?
You really drive a lot. I do. It doesn't say.
No, Tommy.
Yo, I just had the most trippiest dream ever.
Like a close up of your hand taking off.
Pretend you're in like a lot of pain.
Because it's actually what? You don't have like a.
All right, ladies. Wait, am I saying boys?
They start cheering, and then they'll like knock into you, and then you could just be like,
Lexi,
should we have them? Aren't I supposed to have like a bruise here?
Well, right now I'm thinking about.
Promise me that the sophomores are gonna win 3 weeks this year.
Yeah, I thought he was gonna say something.
In case I don't see you, sophomores.
Cry.
What's up, guys?
This is the class of 2025.
And this is our class president's crib.
Welcome to the White House.
So through this door, you'll find our basement.
If you know, you know.
Where the magic happens, you know. A lot of people have been in this basement. Peace. See you next time.
Damn it. I did everything I could not to bomb this test, and I still failed. And Mr. Peterson didn't even do anything to help. What a bozo. This was the final, too. No, I can't settle for this. I gotta fix it. My parents are gonna kill me. Ugh. Wait. What if I change the letter? I gotta be realistic. I can't just add one in here, otherwise that would be an A, and my parents wouldn't believe I got an A. But hey, if I close this up, add one here. Now we got a B. That's more like it. It's an ugly B. My dad will never fall for that B. If only there was a way that, like, Mr. Peterson never became a math teacher. That's some wishful thinking there. He's a jerk. But that's the kind of thing that only happens in movies.
Will?
Doc, how did you get into my house?
Oh, I'm literally living in your walls, but I need you to come over to my house right now. What? It's a matter of importance.
What could it possibly be this time?
It's important. Come on, just.
All right, I'm coming. Fine.
Should I stay or should I go?
Doc, you drive like a madman, and that is not how you wear a seatbelt.
Will, I need you to come quick.
Why are you in such a hurry?
Get out of the car. Here you go.
Why are you in such a hurry?
I made a time machine.
What? Doc, have you been taking your pills again?
You know those pills don't even prevent me from wetting the bed, right?
You made a time machine. Just spare me.
Just come quick. Just come quick. Just please.
Doc, you're not making any sense.
It'll all make sense soon. Just trust me.
What am I even supposed to be looking at here?
This is the time machine.
Wow, you really did take the wrong pills. Doc, do you have any idea what you're talking about?
Enough about my pills. Just hop in. This is important.
All right. Fine. It's so important. Jeez.
There. Happy? What kind of car is this, anyway?
It's a yellow Kia Soul.
Well, yeah, I know it's yellow. Looks like a box of butter.
Will!
I mean, who's even supposed to be driving this thing around?
Will!
It's like you want to get made fun of for owning this.
If this bothers you so much, I have another prototype in my other garage. Is that better?
Well, yeah, why didn't you start with that? I don't want to be associated with this thing.
Well, here you go. Here's my other prototype.
A DeLorean? Doc, how did you...
This thing's a little gas guzzler. In the state of our economy, this is burning a hole in my pocket.
What are you talking about?
It's horrible. This is why I didn't show you at first. Just get in.
All right. Is this supposed to be doing something right now?
There you go.
Whoa. What? Hey, Doc, where all this stuff come from? All right, very funny. You can come out now. Doc? Doc?
Bueller? Bueller? Bueller?
Mr. Brown, he's sick today.
All right.
My best friend's sister's boyfriend's brother's girlfriend heard from this guy who knows this kid, heard that he passed out at Curly's last night.
Thank you. As you all know, today's the big test. Super important. Cheating will not be tolerated in any form.
Yo, you're Johnny Pinoli, right?
It's Peterson. And shut up. Teachers are not talking. And I've never seen in my life a waste story.
Wish I'd never met you either. So I've been looking at this problem. And it's not making much sense to me. I tried using the Pythagorean theorem, but I don't know, man.
This is AP Calc. What are you talking about?
Oh, my bad. Wait, so why don't I know the Pythagorean theorem?
Yo, Spaz, stop talking! What are you doing?
Mr. Peterson, I thought we agreed there'd be no talking. See me after class.
What?
Meet me after class, Mr. Peterson.
Sorry, bro.
Dude, what is your problem? I told you to stop talking and you just didn't.
I'm sorry, man. I was just trying to figure out why we were using the Pythagorean theorem.
This is AP Calc. We don't use a Pythagorean theorem ever.
No need to yell, jabroni.
No, I do need to yell because now I need to go down to the office and they're probably gonna fail me and my grade is gonna plummet. You know what? I don't even need this stupid high school math anyway.
Well, there's no way he's gonna be a math teacher now.
Let's go!
Gotta get back to school. Back to the present, baby. Alright, I'm early for once. Wonder what ever happened to Pinoli. Bet he's not a math teacher.
Oh, no!
Don't love you, you don't love me. Da da da, don't love you, you coming, Mr. Bond. Give me the details. We found him this morning. I think he shattered his cranium. He could have became Homecoming King.
Mr. Principal, I'm glad you called me.
Mr. Bond, I need you on this case immediately. With Homecoming this Friday, I need to assure the safety of my students.
I'll take care of it. Jimmy and Tommy and me, and it was Kai Stabile.
Hey, how you doing?
And we got Anthony Carbone.
Oh, que se dice? Como se va?
And then there was Mo Black's brother, Big Riddy.
How you doing, buddy?
And we can't forget his guys, Nick the Bop.
Staying out of trouble?
Marco No-Nos.
How are you, pal?
And then there was John the Albanian.
I got that thing done for you.
Ian Balls' brother. There was Al Gabagool.
Hey, pal. How's it going?
And you had Cammy Eyes.
What's up, guy?
And Cody Franchese.
Where's that guy? I want to see him.
And Eric Tutan.
Hey, I gotta go get the papers. Get the papers.
Got the nickname because he said everything twice.
So tell me, what happened with your wife last night that has you so upset?
Oh boy. I get home from work, tired and hungry. I go up to my wife. Hey babe, some raviolis would be nice.
Sure honey, anything for you. This chick brings me Chef Boyardee! Oh! Get out of my house! I'm signing the divorce papers as she brought them!
It's a good thing.
Listen, I'm sorry to hear about your raviolis, but you guys hear about that job?
Yeah, boss, we'll get that done for you.
Hey, everyone! Cheers to good health and good raviolis!
Situation so far. Keith Haupt was involved in the incident. He was a Homecoming King candidate. We can rule out Freshman. He's not a suspect. Cerullo, I need you on the killer Colt. He's still a suspect. He was last seen last year in this area in Kinnelon, 07405. Wood, I need you on the homeless guy. He was also last seen in Sabies last year. That would be a huge help to us. We could potentially get a lot of information from him. Lead.
What the heck is that?
Jimmy, did I hit something?
What the heck is that?
I don't know what that is.
Is there a flat?
What? Flat? No, there's no flat.
Well, you better pull over and see.
Is this a Kia Soul?
What you want, DeLorean?
Hi, I'm Freshman. And if you're watching this video, that means administration thought this next part of the scene was a bit of a no-no. Hey, but that's all right. We think you know what was gonna happen next. Anyway, I'll let you get on with your movie now. Oh, juniors, one more thing. A DeLorean? Really? Yeah, right. And we wanted an Aston Martin for our film.
Yeah, but we got an Aston Martin.
What's that?
We have an Aston Martin.
We got an Aston Martin for our senior spirit spot?
Yeah.
With what budget? I'm not even getting paid for this cameo. I mean, are we really serious about this?
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.
I know I'd go from rags to riches. If you would only say you care. And though my pocket may be empty, I'd be a millionaire.
Hi, Jack.
Andrew, have you seen Max anywhere?
No, I haven't seen him at all.
Max Jamal, so you haven't seen him?
Mm-mm.
All right, thank you.
All right, bye, Jack.
Hello there.
Who are you?
I am Obi-Wan Muscovy.
Do you know anything about Max Jamals? Who he is? Where he might be?
No. But Ashley Colombo showed. She's just across the lake over there.
Oh, yeah. There she is, yeah. Thank you.
No problem. But before you go, I must warn you. There is always a bigger fish.
Right. Thank you. Ashley, it's Jack Bond. That old Jedi over there told me you can give me information about Max.
What's a Jedi?
Alright, don't worry about the Jedi. What happened to him? What can you tell me about him?
Well, I think there were men in suits, but they reeked of ravioli and lasagna.
Alright, Ashley, don't worry. We're gonna get him back, alright? I'm on it. Mr. Travolta, why don't you tell me what you know?
Before we start, Mr. Bond, that's a very nice decorative dog you got there.
It's actually, it's a real dog.
It's very still.
Alright, Mr. Travolta.
It's a very well-trained dog.
Listen, why don't you tell me about the incident now?
Alright. So I was walking down Finito Street, so alpha, and I rounded the corner. And I could tell these guys went from 63rd. There was a group of them and they were standing around that Hausler kid. They must have just finished whacking him.
What did they look like?
They were wearing suits, and they reeked of lasagna and gabagool. You know, some good old-fashioned Italian fellas.
Wait, say that again.
Good old-fashioned Italian fellas.
Good old-fashioned Italian. It's the good fellas.
Mr. Bond, I don't think you understand. These ain't no good fellas. These are a bunch of bad fellas. Bubba Coos is gonna need a new manager. Can I leave? That thing hasn't moved an inch.
In Kinnelon, dinner was always a big thing. We had ribs, a pasta course, and a banana for dessert. I did the prep work, and I had this wonderful system for doing the garlic. I used a razor, and I would slice it so thin that it used to liquefy in the pan with just a little oil. Eric was in charge of the ribs. It took him 12 days to learn how to chop it right.
Man, that's what some good pasta sounds like.
Ben was on the pasta, and Roz cooked the meat.
Hey, yo, bud, how do you like your steak?
I like it medium rare.
Ah, an aristocrat.
Huddy peeled the bananas like a moron for 5 hours. Nobody told him to, but he did it anyway.
Man, I wish my wife could cook this good.
Ben was an angry fella.
She cooked like this?
I swear our marriage would be 10 times better.
He loved his wife. He just wouldn't admit it.
Hey, yo, bud, salt that pasta.
So, Ben, how was that Mets game last night?
I didn't catch it. What was the score?
13-0.
Who won?
Not the Mets.
Gotta put some money on that, folks. Hello? You're serious? All right, we'll be right there.
Whoa, what's going on?
Boys, we got a problem down at the Bamboo Lounge.
What is it?
Eric and Huddy, you two head to the lounge. We gotta go head to the warehouse and go get some stuff for this.
What's good, fellas?
In a little cafe, just the other side of the border. He was sitting there giving me looks that made my mouth water. So I started walking her way. She belonged to Batman.
Who's Batman? I got one of the kids at home. I got a daughter. And there's pasta and coconut soy at home. It's your work. I'm like, open it. I'm like, please.
Garcia. Congratulations, Andrew. You definitely earned it.
No!
Hasn't moved in 3 hours. Why am I still here?
Damn it.